Praise be Jesus Christ. Please join us in singing our three hymns, We Three Kings, and Breaking Bread. Hymn number 104. Number 104. Please rise.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have committed sin in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, in my fault. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Thank you.
this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nation by the guidance of the star. Grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears His glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you, dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praise of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit. Namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed in seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Mm.
My brothers and sisters, today we celebrate this beautiful feast of the Epiphany of the Lord. Why it's so important for us? When Mary became pregnant, we know that first she went to Elizabeth, and of course she knew about it. Later on, Joseph was the one who knew about it. And finally, we are moving to Bethlehem, where Jesus is born. And the first people who came to see Jesus, to know him as a Messiah, as a Savior, they were shepherds. But if you look on this group of people, all of them, they were Jews. Later on, when they went to temple, the mystery about Jesus as a Savior was revealed to this old man in the temple and also to Anna. They were Jewish people as well. And today we have three wise men who are approaching Jesus, but they are not Jewish people. It is a sign for us that Jesus was born and later on will sacrifice his life not only for the Jewish people, but for all the nations. And those three men, wise men from the East, represent those different nations. Who are they, these three wise men? Probably they were the one who knew, who were very well educated, the one who possessed knowledge regarding the sky. Probably they also possessed knowledge regarding different signs on earth. But only three men, wise men, discovered this star in the sky. Maybe more. But we have these three wise men who made decision to go, to follow. And of course, they are looking for the king. It could be surprised that they would go directly to Bethlehem. They went to Jerusalem, to the palace of the king, Herod. The scholars are describing that it was the most beautiful palace in the East at that time, Herod Palace. Can you imagine Herod, how he felt at that moment? I don't know if you heard about Herod and his nature, his character, to become the one who have this desire to possess power and become a king. Did you know that Herod, out of fear of losing his power, he killed his father-in-law, he killed his wife, he killed his three sons out of the fear that they were acting against him. And you know what he even said? He said that at the moment of his death, the greatest people of Jewish people should be executed at the day of the death of his. Fortunately, it didn't happen. That means when we heard that words, when the king Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled and all Jerusalem with him. Of course, everybody was terrified. And what he's doing? What is he doing? He's not calling, you know, wise men from Jerusalem. No. He's approaching the chief priests and the scribes of the people. You see, here we have big change. The wise men, they follow the star coming to Jerusalem. And this is what they follow, the natural sign, the sign on the sky. But what happened? It looks like that star brought them to Jerusalem. But from Jerusalem, they were guided by the word of God, delivered to them by by the chief priest and the scribes. You know, it is, for me, it is really amazing because I don't see the conflict between the reason and the faith. It shows beautifully that the reason, our understanding, our intellect, can lead us toward God to some degree. But at some point, it has to be the Word of God to lead us closer and closer to know God and to be immersed in Him. Of course, when they approached Bethlehem, they discovered, they saw that star. It is no conflict between reason and faith. They work mutually together. Person who just believes in intellect will become atheist. Person who just relies on faith and no reason become fanatic. They have to work and go together. Faith and reason. It is now conflict between them. My brothers and sisters, another beautiful thing comes from our gospel today. Magi, when they came to Jerusalem, and maybe they, to some degree, they were disappointed that this is not the place, they didn't went back to their homes. No, they went to Bethlehem. And like the gospel is saying today, they were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. You see, they didn't have in their mind the image of God. They were very flexible, very open. They didn't have, you know, this understanding from the very beginning of their journey that, oh, it will be this way, oh, it will be so spectacular. Absolutely no. They were simply open to find Messiah, the Christ. And very often, my brothers and sisters, we are tempted to do mistake or misunderstand the point that sometimes we have in our understanding, in our head, you know, the image, how it will be when God will provide grace for me, or the way how God looks like, or what kind of graces He will provide. And sometimes, you know, we for years live with some image of it. And when it comes different way, sometimes we miss it. Because maybe God would like to reveal Himself to us totally different way. My brothers and sisters, we have to be flexible. We have to be like this wise man. Be open, because God can surprise us. God can come to us the way we do not expect. We have to have clear mind to be able to accept Him the way He would like to reveal Himself to us. And in many times, it is totally different way than we expect. We cannot have, if I go to each one of you and ask you about your image of God, I guarantee you, each one of us, we will provide different answer. And who is saying the truth? Who is the closest? To some degree, none of us. Because God is different than our imagination. Our understanding of God is very, very small, very partial. And we have to be, our mind has to be way wider, more open for God and the way He would like to reveal Himself to us. Let us pray that when this Epiphany moment comes to us in our personal life, we will not miss it, concentrating and relying on what we already generated. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. On this great day of Epiphany, we bring our petitions to God, confident that He hears and answers our prayers this day.
For the Holy Father, Pope Francis, those who serve the Church, and for all people who preach and practice the Gospel of Christ, let us pray to the Lord. For political leaders, that they may be blessed with integrity and humility as they serve the people they represent. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who suffer in mind, body, or soul, that they may know the love of Jesus through the tender care of others, let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially for Francis and Walter Samson, that they will be welcomed in the fullness of eternal joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community, that the Lord may magnify the treasures we bring to Jesus, who give us all that is good. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, as we join the wise men in adoration and praise, we bring you this and all our intentions, trusting that you hear and answer your children. We ask this and all our prayers through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Watch out.
sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on this gift of your church in which you are offered now, not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed and received in Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations, and when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly night, Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate through Christ our Lord. Starting tomorrow, January 7th, morning masses will be in the chapel, not in the church. Tomorrow we will begin our annual house blessing, Colenda. The schedule with dates and street names can be found by every entrance to the church. Prayer Cenacle for the Marian Movement of Priests will be held Sunday, January 13th, at 4 p.m. in the chapel. Everyone is invited to come and pray the rosary. March for Life this year will take place on January 18th. Anyone who is interested in going may reserve a seat by calling their contact in the bulletin or the rectory during the week. My brothers and sisters, in our tradition, on the feast of the Epiphany of the Lord, we bless chalk and incense. And immediately after final blessing, I'd like to ask you to approach the altar and take with you to your home and the chalk and incense. And now let us pray to Saint Michael the Archangel. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the battle.
now I will bless the chalk and incense. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord God, this chalk, to render it helpful to men. Grant that they who use it in faith and with inscribe upon the entrance of their homes the names of their saints, Caspar, Melchior, and Balthazar, may through their merits and intercession enjoy health of body and protection of soul. O God, who art invisible and without end, in the holy and awesome name of the Son, graciously bestowed blessing, power, these creatures, gold, incense, and myrrh, protect those who will have them in your possession from illness, injury, and danger to body and soul, so they can joyfully and securely serve thee with zeal in the church. Through Christ our Lord. And for this coming week, priest, receive God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks.
Have a blessed weekend.